Yeah.
Hello.
You two, come on, you ready?
Yes.
You got me?
I made a new friend today.
That's what I do. And there's the wife making friends today.
But I'm going to see it.
In Mullingar that night I rested limb so weary, started by daylight, me spirits bright, and ere he took a drop of the pure, keep me heart from sinking, that's the Paddy's cure, whenever he's on for drinking, to see the lassie smile, laughing all the while, at me curious style, would set your heart to bubbling, and asked if I was hard, wages I required, till I was nearly tired of the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hut the hare and turn her down the rocky road, all the way to Dublin, whack full ollie ra. In Dublin next arrived, I thought it such a pity to be so soon deprived of view of that fine city. Well then I took a stroll, all among the quality bundle it was stole, all in a neat locality, something crossed me mind, when I looked behind the bundle could I find upon me sick a woman inquiring for the road, said me Connacht Road wasn't much in vogue on the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hut the hare and turn her down the rocky road, all the way to Dublin, whack for lully ra.
Irish breakfast.
Yeah. I'm having a little trouble this morning. I think one of the drawbacks of me having Guinness is the fact that I might get some gas. Made the mistake of going through the tunnel. Mm-hmm. Paid
$10 pull.
Yeah, you're here. Don't take the tunnel.
Destroyed. Just started.
I'm just starting. Typical for us.
Mm-hmm.
He's done within 2 minutes, and I'm just getting prepared.
Then I can just stare at your beauty while you eat.
Mm-hmm. I'm still trying to figure out my blood sausage here. I think I like it.
It's good.
But I'm not sure, but I think I like it.
It's good. It's all good.
It's different.
You like it too.
It's different.
Roundabout.
Don't listen to her. Shut up. Shut up, Tony.
Exit the roundabout onto Cypress Grove Road.
My gas stations. You can fill up, right? Or you can come here
and do your laundry.
That's where I do my laundry. At the gas station.
That is multitasking to a T.
Probably because the pumps are so slow, it takes you that long to fill up. Sounds like a damn generator.
Laundry. You know what? Pump
up my gas,
go to the store, grab paper, grab coffee to go.
Noah.
Noah.
Where
are
we going, baby?
I have no idea. We're going to see the garden.
The garden, yeah.
Except I don't know where.
Powerscourt.
Powerscourt.
We're going to Powerscourt.
Okay.
And we're on the M50 heading south right now.
It's the largest waterfall in Ireland.
Mm-hmm.
So we are headed to the largest waterfall in Ireland.
It's also in the States.
And that is in...
Hugging the tree.
It's like a big old fat guy.
My tree. I love the tree. Incredible. There are no words to describe this. Absolutely incredible. Yes.
This is your paradise.
Oh.
Ariel!
See, this is what I'm talking about. This is what I go to. Yeah. Those are excellence.
You didn't see nothing. You didn't see nothing.
What's it called?
The Powerscourt Gardens.
You did it.
Yeah.
Wait, isn't it Powerscourt?
Powerscourt.
Powerscourt.
Oh.
It's Chowder.
I love Chowder. You too.
Chowder. Chowder. It's Chowder. Say it right. Chowder.
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 So beautiful.
It's on you, baby.
Okay. So we're in Powerscourt, Ireland right now. We just finished up at one of the most majestic gardens of the world. Rated number 3 by National Geographic. Amazing. I didn't want to leave. The only reason why I did agree to leave is because my husband's taking me to a castle.
So I don't want to leave.
And it's not every day when you can tell her, baby, we have to leave the gardens so we can get to the castle.
Only in Ireland. I love Ireland. So you can't say no to that. And right now we are headed to Kilkenny. So our next stop is Kilkenny.
Which, how often can you say that, baby? We have to get to the castle.
We have to leave the gardens to get to the castle. It doesn't get any better than that. That's Ireland.
Son, isn't that enough?
We're here.
As I was going over the far-famed Kerry Mountains, I met with Captain Farrell and his money he was counting. I first produced me pistol and I then produced me rifle.
That's how you reenact stuff.
And as ever, for you were a bold receiver, mushering the food and that. Where called the daddy-o? Where called the daddy-o? There's whiskey in the jar. I
found the door. And this is it.
I think it's wonderful. It's everything I dreamed it would be. That's it. Little tiny tower, sure.
Very tiny. Tiny, tiny, tiny. Everything.
It's like a little hobbit house.
It is.
It's perfect for you.
Wait a minute. Do you have to go to the bathroom? I wonder what's down there. Looks like a button and some pedals. Let's take a look. Oh, this is where you go. It's like a little hobbit bathroom. It's perfect for you.
Reminds me of the toilet in the hotel room. Not the hotel, the hospital.
Yeah.
This is a working farm. So they actually, they have cows out there.
This is
they'll let
place
us milk.
Number 2, but our first bed and breakfast in
first.
Ireland. So first bed and breakfast, Kilkenny, Ireland.
Yeah, we're at the Rise.
We're at the Rise.
Kilkenny. And not really like it's living up to the name because it's not
yes.
Short.
This is our hobbit room. It's really tiny, small, quaint.
Yeah, you know what?
Table.
You know what I can do? Okay.
Almost here.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I can plank the whole room.
Just about.
Okay, just
about. Checking. You get a little extra room right by the door. This is our little hobbit room.
Yes.
County Carlo! Welcome to County Carlo. On your way to County Kilkenny.
The light.
streets of London are far behind. The thoughts of homeland.
Yeah.
That's us. Maybe I should go up more.
Jagger?
I think so.
So we're at Kilkenny.
Kilkenny.
Kilkenny Castle. Built in 1195.
Right?
They don't let you take video inside.
Yeah. But we took pictures.
And I do what I want because I'm a driver. So what you're about to see is probably video of the inside of the castle.
So we did get video.
No, we didn't. So it's cool. Definitely check it out. This is our first castle.
Yeah. First castle that we're visiting in Ireland. 1195.
That's all we know.
Yeah.
We're not good tour guides.
We're about to find out more.
Nobody stole it. That's good.
What do you think?
Beautiful.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Don't show my wife this. Do not. I repeat, do not. After you.
Things are here. Okay.
Thank you.
Just to ensure, sir, there's no.
Sweet.
Oh, wow. Well, that's why they're good, so you can see it here.
Oh, wow. Hey there, bub. If you move, I swear to God, I'm gonna punch you. That's some cool stuff. Oh, that's cool.
Oh, here it is. Okay. Here we go.
They're private?
Tony, don't be stupid. Tony.
Come on now.
Come on.
You come back here before you get your ass in the face.
You fall. Oh, you're a dick. Stupid.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, no.
There you go.
Me getting you, getting me.
Yeah.
Awesome. This is cool. It's much cooler in person. They even have play castles for the kids.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. Yeah. There's a big play castle over there. There's the play castle for the kids. Side of the street.
They just love me here.
They do.
First the D.
D, right? Hotel.
First the D Hotel. And now
the Dillon Whiskey Bar.
Don't worry, Ireland. We love you too.
Yes.
We love you.
All right. Go to a pub.
Well, you're walking through a city street, you could be in Peru, and you hear a distant calling, and you know it's meant for you. Then you drop what you were doing, and you join the merry mob, and before you know just where you are, you're in an Irish pub. They've got one in Honolulu, they've got one in Moscow too, they got four of them.
Licenses and stuff?
I guess. Get your passport? I have mine.
I don't have one on me. No. Back at the hotel.
I don't know what just happened.
And maybe he's like, nope, too many cards are being held up, so he's letting someone let them happen.
Maybe.
Or they're doing like every couple. Like.
Yeah, just random.
Yeah. Ooh, that scares me because we're going to a pub. So.
I know.
Should we maybe only just have one drink and that's it?
That sounds about right. Sorry. What'd you say?
5-star shower.
Yeah? I just find it funny that you're as tall as that part of the door.
I'm serious, yeah. Hi.
Hi.
I just wanted to inform you that this shower is incredible. Everything is old and rustic, old world, right?
Yeah.
The showers. Showers and coffee in Ireland.
Those are the two things that matter the most.
I've never been to so many places where every single time the coffee is perfect and their hot showers galore. I am a happy person.
You remember this moment forever.
I know.
Please.
You're going to put in a video.
And remember forever too. So next time you're mad at me. Yeah.
So you can imagine how this is for me. What, you know, 5 foot.
It's a perfect house for you.
This is like 3.5 feet ceiling.
When I was just a baby, my mother told me, son, we'll always be a good boy, don't ever play with a gun. And I shot a man in the window just to watch him die. And I hear the whistle blowing, I hear my head crying.
We had them in there. We took them out.
Now they're back.
And now they're back.
We have no power this morning.
No, we don't know why.
I don't know why. We have no power. Nothing works. I can't pee because nothing will work.
Absolute destruction.
How's it going?
Going good.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Well, okay.
Hello.
Would you care if any jams or that? No? Okay?
I'm okay, thank you. Okay. Yeah. She's really nice. I like her.
Yeah.
street. How is this two lanes? This is awesome.
Right.
I don't have anywhere to go. Yeah.
Oh, this guy, I'm like.
Hello. Ow.
I hit my head.
It was beautiful. No drone.
How much I have a.
To the no.
Hell to the no. To the no, 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 no. Hell no, no.
To the no, no.
You okay?
Yeah. Only hit my head twice.
Oh, there's an achievement.
Achievement unlocked. Good luck.
You don't worry, I'm turning.
I lost my way. Let's go find her again.
Take your pictures of the moss.
Of the moss?
Yeah, it's like crystallizing. They have moss growing in the cave, but it's like a beautiful, mystical crystallizing is like happening with that. I'm just mesmerized. It's wow.
It's mystical.
Yeah. If you get a chance to come to Blarney Castle in Cork.
Blarney.
Yeah. Blarney Castle in Cork. You got to come and you got to go through the caves.
This place is really neat. Yeah. Right? This would be a great first date.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. The caves. If I had a sandwich, we would have lunch here. Garden. That doesn't sound right. Let's go check it out.
The poison garden.
Oh, it really is poisonous.
Yeah.
I thought it was like, you know, folklore, cool. They have cages around the stuff. That's hilarious. What? Pretty big. Yeah. The grounds are pretty big. This is a pharma industry lot.
That's
okay.
Found the three wise men. Apparently, they've never heard of Mole, Larry, and Curly. No. You know, there's one thing they don't tell you about going through those little caves in there. Is that these people must have gotten wedgies from bending down and getting up. Bending down and getting up. I got one. It's my travel tip. They have cool little things everywhere. For example, we found this.
The awesome game of hide and seek for the kids. Vicky would have a field day.
Could you imagine if Tony was here?
I do what I want, I'm a child.
Ireland would never be the same.
No.
It's beautiful, it's huge. There's so much to see and do. I don't know how that's a lookout tower, it's not that tall. Look, baby, it's a hobbit tower.
Exactly.
Your kind of tower. Look out, tower. You're half the height of the tower.
A little main kitchen.
Yeah, do a little remodeling, right? Yeah. You know?
All you need is a rocking chair.
You got like, maybe you can climb the walls for entertainment.
Give me a rocking chair.
That's all you can get in there.
Yeah, I can sleep in the chair.
I don't get how this is a lookout tower.
I don't care.
Because you can't look out of anything. You just make a fire.
My favorite forget-me-nots. There's a spring, they only bloom in early spring, but here in Ireland, they last a lot longer than they do in the U.S. They bloom a lot longer. Yeah, they'll bloom into early summer. By us, they only have like a week and a half where you get to see the blooms, but they bloom a lot longer here in Ireland. And it's only March. It's March 16th, and look at this. This is full. Look how full this is. It's in bloom. This is so beautiful. Like, I can't believe how much is in bloom, and it's only mid-March.
The weather changes every 5 minutes around here. It's raining. What do you think so far?
Beautiful.
Yeah. We're in the poison garden. I didn't even know this existed here. So one of those things, if you come here, they have a poisonous garden. Except they have pot in there, and that's not poisonous. That's medicinal. I am not endorsing for the sale of pot. But that's medicinal. No, but everything else is poisonous. I'm sitting around poison. Think I can put something in my bag?
There's like a mysterious presence. No, leave it alone.
What, you think there's like little elves here?
No, just ancient.
Yeah. It's not like there's a minion dancing around us or something. Okay, so like that. Don't fall in. Baby, they have dolphins here. Baby, look.
Headed down south to the land of the pine. I'm from Norway and North Carolina. Staring up the road, pretty God, I see headlights. I'm headed down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a food.
Where are we?
Cork, Ireland.
And there's the English market.
Ireland's longest fish counter. This guy right here.
Mama, anyway you feel, hey, hey, mama, rock me.
Absolute destruction.
I already know what she's gonna come back with. Laugh my f***ing ass off. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you for the warning. That's what you say. Thanks for the warning.
Basically, yeah.
I'm just being straight up with you, man. Yeah. Donuts. Come sit out. Laugh my ass. Told you.
Your Sword in the Stone imitation.
Excalibur! What is a sword sticking out of the road?
So much enthusiasm.
You don't see that.
No.
You don't see that every day.
You can see crosses in the south. You know, like right next to the pawn shop. Out here you see like random swords. Giant swords. Giants.
Yeah.
We're gonna go bushing. What's bushing?
Bushing. In Galway, you get yourself a couple beers. And you go sit by the Spanish Arch, and you have your beers by the Spanish Arch, and it's called Ocean.
It's always like a college town.
It's a huge college town. And it's where Lord of the Rings
was
written, at least part of it. Gandalf!
The bogs?
Okay, there's some of the bogs. We're going really fast.
We have an opening here.
There's a bog. The bogs of Ireland.
I need those coats, man. Yeah. No one's gonna believe me back in the States I dressed like this.
I have proof. Oh, okay.
People dress like this in Boston, other than Boston, for real. I'm like that about it. That's the only way that people are like very green, or like very aggressive. But it makes sense because there's a lot of Irish people in Boston.
That's true.
Yeah.
We were there last year.
Were you?
Yeah,
so fun, right?
We saw the whole fat famine statue they have there.
Do it first!
I just need a top hat.
Yeah.
I like it.
Oh, look at what's next to us. Good job.
Galway knows me, right? My name, Dylan Thomas.
Nothing more to feed his head. Everything says Dylan on it.
Mom, thank you. You made me a happy man.
Indeed you were.
Yeah.
It was really the worst day we've had in all of the year.
Oh. Really?
Yeah, it was rough.
The wind is what really catches you with the rain, doesn't it?
It destroyed my umbrella.
Oh!
Yeah, it fucked the other way around.
Oh dear me, that was dreadful. Oh dear.
Serving us our English coffee, our Irish coffee.
That's nice. You left it up there for your service. That's lovely. Well, yeah, lovely, yeah. Lovely.
There are two of you. Oh, I'm in heaven right now. Oh, wait, come back. At least one of you. Ah, oh, there she is.
Danger.
You're wearing the bowl.
Wow, no entry.
Random castles. This everywhere.
These walls here are just engineered perfectly, right? Everywhere is like stone walls, right? This stuff. Or Ireland has never had an earthquake. Because I would hate cleaning this stuff up.
Yeah, so this is a lot of what you see. It's just kind of stone scattered everywhere, but they use it all to separate their property lines. You can probably see more down there. I didn't have a good parking spot.
Yeah, you definitely don't get this back in the States.
Look at that, right there. It's a dangerous Irish cattle. One small move and I'm a dead man. I'm gonna touch him. He's looking at me.
Run.
Look over there, right there. It's a tiger. Could kill a man in 10 seconds. I'm gonna touch it.
Look at this.
This is like a little gem.
Everywhere we go, we find a cemetery. I'm going in. I'm checking it out. I'm here. I really hope I don't get in trouble. I don't want to piss anybody off, but...
caretaker cemetery.
Yeah.
Old.
I'm getting wet. You can feel some old spirits here. I'm telling you. It just feels ancient. Ancient cemeteries.
We just had the caretaker come up to us as we're going out.
Why the f*** these Americans do this? You want to look at gravestones, you stick bastard.
You're taking pictures. Every day there's Americans taking pictures by the graves.
This is my dad aunt from 9 centuries ago.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I have left my mark in Ireland. Thank you.
Yeah, it won't be a minute now.
We came all the way from Chicago to see this.
Oh, you're very welcome. It's a pity about the weather.
Hi. It's a pity. We promised like this the rest of the day. Well, let's make the best of it. Maybe we'll catch a break in the fog.
Yeah.
That would be good. As long as I don't drive off the cliff right now.
Yeah, no kidding. We know it won't be packed.
Yeah.
We're at the Cliffs of Moher. It's spelled Moher, but it's pronounced Moher.
Yep.
Yeah. A little bit of crappy weather, kind of like yesterday. But we're going to make the best of it. A woman said that it's probably going to be like this the whole time.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're
here.
We made it. We're waiting for that 1 hour break because the weather said it was supposed to clear up for an hour. So.
Yeah, we got an hour or two. I don't know. We'll see.
This is neat. This is the entrance when you walk into the cliffs. They take you through like a little tour area. Kind of neat, right? Yeah, you have like a whole museum, the history of it. The future of Ireland, they have a map over there that shows you what it's going to look like in 50 million years from now. Dublin's going to be underwater. But Florida's still there. Think about it. In a minute and a half. Let's go check it out. On those dolphins around here. Mm-hmm. We saw these. Yeah, we saw them in the water. Okay, that was neat, but I want to experience this in real life. I'm not here to watch it on a screen like you guys. See, another reason to come to Ireland, to experience it in real life.
That's gonna be terrific.
Yeah?
Oh, I hope so. You see everything.
Yeah, with all that fog and everything.
You better button up. It's about 70 miles an hour.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I'm excited for that. So it begins.
They're gone.
Oh, yeah.
They're already gone. You can't see them anymore.
We'll probably see them if we keep heading up. Good.
This is as real as it gets. This is real Ireland. All the stuff you see, those nice fancy pictures, those are like once a month.
Yeah.
This is Ireland.
Yeah.
This is the weather.
This is Ireland.
Yeah.
I'd hold on to your hats. I lost mine over there.
Oh,
not kidding.
Thank you.
Yeah.
How'd you get it?
I ran.
Well, we tried. I lost my hat, and I had to run to get it. We're heading back down.
Yeah, so this is Paul Maloney Pottery, and he's from Wexford, the potter from Wexford. Himself and his wife, Patricia, run their company. This is the Seagreaves range. So it's really popular here in Ireland. It's really pretty. And it's like, yeah, with daisies and pink and blue and everything. So yeah, they're lovely.
The missus is going to get that. And I'm going to get my book. Stopped off at the Moher Cottage, got ourselves some cappuccinos or American espressos. And she told us about a little hidden gem over here we're going to go check out. It's walking distance, maybe 10 minutes. So let's go take a look at this. Everywhere we go, you're going to find us in a cemetery somewhere. But this one is really... That's some pretty amazing stuff here. Some of these are newer, and then you have some of them that are really, really old. Let's go check it out up there. This one is a couple hundred years old. Pretty wild around here. Many, many, many Celtic crosses. Many. Hello, love. We went in through the back way. Are you okay? We got this way. We gotta go into here. She said I can go in, but I don't know about that. I mean, it doesn't look like anyone's been here for a while. What you're looking at is the wishing well that St. Bridget came at the time of St. Patrick in around 450 AD. And they say that if you, wish into the well, you will be healed. It was a healing well. And now people use that, for memories of their lost loved ones. And that's been dating back for 1500 years, over 1500 years now. That's what you're looking at right there. That's spiritual right there. It really humbles you to see that, that old. That's Ireland.
To forget you.
I said that in Scottish language.
There, wolf. There, castle.
Werewolf.
Werewolf?
There, wolf. There, castle.
You have been waiting for this moment the entire trip.
Yeah.
Okay.
My entire life.
Your whole life.
My dream home. The thatched house.
A little bit about this edge forest.
I will later.
Pretty cool though.
Ready.
I'm taking a move of you, taking a picture of me, taking a move of you. I see you, see me, see you.
I see her in the goddamn trunk. I see her, see me, see her in the goddamn trunk.
Man, can you imagine a roof made out of straw? Well, imagine no more. It's like bamboo. I just broke the roof.
The dreams of a prosperous farmer.
Really? The dwelling of a prosperous farmer. We just came inside somebody's house. This is pretty neat. Whole fireplace.
Can you see in here?
Yeah, baby.
This is supposed to be the kitchen. Look at the fireplace. Oh my god.
Jeez. There's a lot of them. There's just crows everywhere.
I don't know if you can hear, but they're just laughing at everybody. I need Arnold to yell out, "Stop laughing!"
Look at the two donkeys.
Hey. It's good. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddies. I have a donkey friend, too. His name is Cork, though. Yeah. The Irish donkeys. There's Shrek. Oh, there's Shrek.
So what you're looking at, that's called peat. That was the firewood they used back in the day.
Yeah, they would dig it out of a bog and then you let it dry. They would dry it out and then you use it to heat the fireplace or to have a bonfire. But they never used firewood, they always used peat, and which comes in abundance in Ireland with all the bogs. Yeah.
That's the after effect, yeah.
Cut them out in bricks, so they look like bricks, and then they would dry them, and then you can use them for firewood. That would be your firewood.
They look like starter logs.
Kind of, yeah.
Maybe they really are and we don't know any better.
No. No, I did my research.
Okay. She knows this part.
Wow.
That's pretty neat. We have dinner in the castle right now.
Medieval dinner.
Shami.
Good evening.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Where are you from?
Chicago.
Yep.
Tea with you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Seriously?
Do you bring them everywhere?
I do.
Really?
Aww.
Okay. All right. Just this once. Don't bring them back again.
No, okay. Here, take the knife out of my bag for this. No, I'm just kidding.
You're very welcome. You're going.
I got burned bad. Hello. Oh, thank you.
amber liquid in your goblets is mead. Your mead has been made from honey fermented fruit of the vine. Now here in our time, mead was very plentiful. And it was particularly favored by newly married couples. We believe that the honey in the mead was good for fertility and virility. The newlyweds would drink the mead for 1 month or 1 noon after the wedding ceremony. Hence the expression,
honey moon. Look it up. My noblest guests, the toast here at my lord's castle is Soja is sail, which means good health and long life to you. Each time the toast is proposed, you may raise your goblets on high. Even if you don't have one, raise it on high. Pretend. And repeat after me. Sláinte is sail.
Sláinte is sail.
Well done, my noble guests. Well done. Now.
I'm not really supposed to stand here, you do realise.
You
just have a drink, probably. Yeah. Thank you, my lord.
Thank you. Lord.
Thank you, my lady.
Hello, baby.
Just imagine.
One person falls.
We're all dead.
So much harder to be.
On this dish, the chef begs your opinion on this dish. All things considered, you'd be well advised to like it.
Wow. No pressure.
No pressure. My lord approves!
Yay!
You love your wife, right?
You're the only person you would afford.
Right. Right. Aren't you royalty?
Hi there. Anybody? 20-year-old.
I bring you the most alarming news. Oh. Oh, far more alarming than that. Oh. You're so dramatic. We have a scoundrel in our room.
Lord Nate.
Very sick. Perfect human.
What shall we do? On your knees before your Lord. Both knees, you're not proposing. My Lord, look at his sweet innocent little. Surely, Lord, Nate is too young and handsome to die this night. My Lord, what might he do that you would consider forgiving him his crime? My Lord must agree, one voice.
I think a lovely song would be very good.
My heart reminded me, the idea here was to punish him, not the messenger. However, be upstanding and sing us a noble song from the noble land far away. Make a good one of our new career on that.
Row, row, row.
Yeah, for dinner, they kick you down a cave.
Easy, my lord. Yeah. Fair enough.
Kick you down to the dungeon.
Hungry on the left there, buddy.
This is kind of cool. To bid you a farewell tonight. Good night. What's wrong with your hair? Perfect. Saturday night, date side, please.
What are you eating?
I'm eating porridge.
Porridge?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, please.
Yeah.
Can I have some porridge? But it is good.
It's good, right?
It's just oatmeal, but...
Yeah, I don't care. It's in, you're in Ireland, and it's porridge.
Uh-huh.
So it's different. Porridge. That's right. It's better.
It's hot.
Trinity.
Yeah. It is good.
Trinity College in Dublin.
Yeah, we made it. 7 days later, we're here. And we started here. Let's take a look around.
Country which dates from the 1690s, but all the rest of the buildings around Front Square here are 18th century.
You got salt in your teeth.
Look at this. It looks like as big as my hand.
Clung. Clung.
That is an awesome door.
Yeah, we need that at home.
Like, welcome to my front door. This is my door. You want to go through the door? You may go through my door. Knock first.
I'm waiting for the line head to move and the little elf pop out.
Like the labyrinth.
Yeah. He's going to spit on you, watch out.
He's offering me a Guinness.
Come out of his mouth? We are here.
See the Book of Kells in Trinity College, make sure you get here early. All that just to go in there. That's a lot of people. And more are coming. My homie. This is my favorite one so far because his name is Bacon. F Bacon. F Bacon. I picked up one of the books and I read it. And now I can do this. Pretty cool. That's why they won't let you read the books. Exactly why. It's neat though.
Yeah, you can request it. And then there's two reading rooms inside of the library. And they will bring the book to me, they will handle the book. And do research.
Can we request
it? One day you'll be able to go online and request anything from you.
Can we request to go read a book right now? Mm-hmm. Give you 20 euros.
I don't. I think they should come out.
I'll try it for him. He told me no.
Is that the Book of Kells?
No.
Oh, okay.
You know where it is?
No. There's nobody here that works here? No. Oh, he's trying to get us in the picture.
Oh, no, I was getting everybody in the picture.
Oh, not us.
No. I mean, I can if you guys want to take a selfie.
Do you know where the Book of Kells is? Is it downstairs?
The first one when you walked in.
The first one we walked in?
Yeah, the two rooms.
The actual example was the...
There's the three books in the front room, and then there's the two books in the second room.
Oh.
Yeah. It's definitely worth it.
I took a peek at it.
It's worth it?
It's definitely worth it.
Really?
Yeah, it's old. Faith, I guarantee you, you would never be out of stuff to read. If you lived here, I wouldn't want to hear it.
I thought that was my cell phone. I was
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
This guy looked like he had a great night.
Him too.
Each cup represents a story. This guy here, dead, is stole all the shillings from her, right? But the rats ran away with their food. And they got mad and they chased after them.
You just missed story time with Dee.
I'm sure.
Yeah. What do you think?
What do I think?
What do you think about this magnificent place?
I'm in awe.
You're in awe?
Yeah.
I am too.
Absolutely.
It's beautiful.
Absolutely.
It's a beautiful place.
It was founded by Queen Elizabeth the First.
Yeah.
That's a little... To Elizabeth, you have something to aspire to. Seriously.
If you come to Ireland, you have to come see Trinity College. It's just mesmerized. It's silent to you. It's amazing walking through the long room. The Book of Kells.
Phenomenal. I couldn't take photography and they didn't allow you to. And I didn't want to get kicked out. So.
Want to be in the moment anyway, so it's almost better that you can't take pictures. You're not concentrating on taking pictures. You're just in the moment, and
that's perfect. I can help myself. I photobombed somebody.
Dylan likes to work in with the locals.
I do.
Talk to everybody.
Yeah, get to know them. All right, let's go get some food, and then we're on to Clontarf. Castle for tea.
Irish tea. Have fun. I'm happy. I'm having tea in a castle in Ireland. I have no complaints. I have no complaints. This is my bucket list.
That's true.
This is a bucket list item. I'm having afternoon tea in a medieval castle in Ireland.
You're welcome.
Dream come
true. Yeah, get a brownie point.
I have the most amazing husband in the world. He knows his wife. He knows his wife. So, after my half hour discussion on Shakespeare with him.
I got you saying that on camera.
Don't get me started on Shakespeare.
Yeah.
In music, though, one doesn't make the end of a composition the point of the composition. If that were so, the best conductors would be those who played fastest. And there would be composers who wrote only finales. People go to a concert just to hear one crashing chord, because that's the end. Same way in dancing. You don't aim at a particular spot in the room. That's where you should arrive. The whole point of the dancing is the dance.
You've arrived.
We thought of life by analogy with a journey, with a pilgrimage, which had a serious purpose at the end, and the thing was to get to that end, success or whatever it is, or maybe heaven after you're dead. But we missed the point the whole way along. It was a musical thing, and you were supposed to sing or to dance while the music was being played.
Hello. Red Trim Castle. This is where Braveheart was filmed. Braveheart. We must go up there and reenact the most famous scenes. We can establish freedom here. Is that Scottish? Is it Irish? I don't know, yeah.
A little bit of both.
A little bit of column A, a little bit of column B. All right, let's check it out.
Beautiful.
Don't see any freedom around here. There? No. Let's check out somewhere else. We can find this freedom. This is neat. Oh, shit. Don't fall. It's a steep steps. Sir William Wallace would know. He probably built him with his hands. Freedom's got to be around here somewhere. We're going to find it. We're going to bring it back to my people.
Give me a horse.
And a boogie. No freedom here. Yeah, I think this is a f***ing joke. Saving freedom like this with... It's got to be down here somewhere. To find this. We'll to find it now. No freedom here. None. We're not even along these walls. Maybe in there. No. No freedom down there. Absolutely not. None. This is pretty neat. They keep freedom locked up. They don't want it to get it out. This is where we just walked. There's the grotto over there. You got the lake. It shows you this dirt lookout tower thing. Some steps. And there it is. That is my beauty. No. Come back here. Let's see. Oh yeah, here we go. No freedom back here. It's locked in. Mm-hmm. A lot of moths. But no freedom. I think I better bust out the drone, try to find that freedom. I don't think they allow that here, but I'm a driver, I do what I want. Freedom.
No, it's not on there.
Fucking bloke.
No, I think there's a dragon down there.
You know, that just falls on you. It's gonna make for a really bad day. See that fell over there? Ugh, that suck. I mean, seriously. Think about this. Has Ireland never had an earthquake?
I don't think so
either. It's skinnier and then it gets fatter on top. Nope. Couldn't find my freedom. Wait a minute. That's where my freedom is.
I love you too.
I love you. Smooth move, Dylan. Smooth move.
Very smooth. How romantic. Can you imagine them building this?
Oh God. The amount of stone? Yeah, I don't know, because you got to cut them each too.
I mean, it's amazing. Yeah.
Think about building that. The wall is going sideways over the air. That's incredible. Laughs at me. My freedom. Freedom's right here. That's my freedom. Mm-hmm. She's laughing at me.
Let's suppose that you were able every night to dream any dream you wanted to dream. And that you could, for example, have the power within one night to dream 75 years of time. Or any length of time you wanted to have. And you would naturally, as you began on this adventure of dreams, you would fulfill all your wishes. You would have every kind of pleasure you could conceive. And after several nights of 75 years of total pleasure each, you would say, "Wow, that was pretty great. But now let's have a surprise. Let's have a dream which isn't under control. Well, something is going to happen to me that I don't know what it's going to be." And you would dig that and come out of that and say, "Wow, that was a close shave, wasn't it?" And then you would get more and more adventurous, and you would make further and further out gambles as to what you would dream. And finally, you would dream where you are now. You would dream the dream of living the life that you are actually living today. That would be within the infinite multiplicity of choices you would have, of playing that you weren't God. Because the whole nature of the Godhead, according to this idea, is to play that he's not. The first thing he says to himself is, "Man, get lost." Because he gives himself away. The nature of love is self-abandonment, not clinging to oneself. Throwing yourself out, as in, for example, in basketball, you're always getting rid of the ball. You say to the other fellow, "Have a ball." See? And that keeps things moving. That's the nature of life. So in this idea then, everybody is fundamentally the ultimate reality. Not God in a politically kingly sense, but God in the sense of being the self, the deep down basic whatever there is. And you're all that, only you're pretending you're not. Together, to pluck wild.